Honestly, I feel like every couple of months, some new tool comes along, which suddenly becomes this major blocker for Windows users coming over to Linux. And in this case, it's not even a new tool. It's been around for going on 7 years. It's just fairly recently that people have actually been talking about it. That tool is lossless scaling. And I think part of the reason why the discussion is fairly recent is because the scaling part isn't what people have been talking about. Instead, they have been talking about the frame gen, otherwise known as playing video games and generating fake frames. Now, I have said my piece on fake frames many, many times, and judging by the fact that I'm using the term fake frames, you can probably guess my opinion on fake frames. And maybe that's a topic to address in a dedicated video. Nonetheless, though, people do really like the tool. If you want a really good breakdown on how the tech actually works, why you might want to use it, some of the drawbacks of this method compared to the conventional solutions from AMD and Nvidia, there is a really good video from Digital Foundry. Keep in mind this is from over a year ago, it's using an older version of lossless scaling, since then there's been a newer version which is supposed to be considerably better. It still fundamentally works the same way, so it's going to have some of those similar sorts of issues, just less so. There's also a more recent video from Daniel Owen. I'll leave both of these linked in the description down below. Be sure to go check them out if that sounds interesting to you. Now, the official application that you can get on Steam, this is a Windows application. And unlike a lot of other tools which are Windows applications, this is a Windows application. You are not running this through Proton. That is not going to do anything productive. You can probably open up the UI, but like the actual thing that you want it to do, the frame generation, the scaling, the Windows version was not going to work, and it would need to be fundamentally changed to work on Linux. Well, it's super early, it's super experimental, and not guaranteed to work on anything that isn't Arch, but a start is a start, and a start is important, as first reported by Gaming on Linux. lsfg-vk aims to bring lossless scaling frame generation to Linux. Someone is working on a port. Somebody is trying to bring this tool over to Linux, not the entirety of the tool, but the part that people really care about right now. The frame generation part. The thing that I'm legitimately seeing people say that if they don't have lossless scaling, they don't want to swap over to Linux. Like, this is how quickly people get used to some tool they use and don't want to let it go. If you'd like to use it right now, this is the main installation method. Curling a script. I've said my piece on curling scripts. Also, this is made for Arch and its derivatives. There is no guarantee it's going to work on anything else. If you are not on Arch, or if you are on Arch and aren't comfortable doing that, basically, you're going to have to go and build it from source. All of the information is here for Arch, for Ubuntu, for Debian, which is basically Ubuntu, for Fedora. And if you're on anything else, you can adapt these to what you need to do. Also, because we are doing this on Linux, the way you set it up is a bit different from Windows. Like things like Mango Hard and various other tools like that, OBS VK Capture, it is something you add into the launch options of the application. So if you're launching outside of Steam, it would look something like this. If you're launching it inside of Steam, if you've ever had to do any launch options, it's the exact same way you go and do those. There is a couple of options we have. Firstly is enabling the frame generation. Then is the multiplier, so the frame rate that you want to aim for. This right here, LSFG DLL path, this is mainly going to be a sort of debug feature. This is something where if you want to override the DLL it's loading, you can go and do that. Most people are probably never going to have to touch this unless they want to go and load an older version of it. There is obviously some logging options, so debug log and where you want the file to actually be located. If you're using HDR, and only if you're using HDR, you can toggle that as well. Do not toggle that if you're not using it. Things will go badly for you. What the result's gonna be? Well, hey, maybe try it out and see what happens. We have LSFG flow scale. This is basically the quality option. So lowering this is gonna have less quality, and this can improve performance and reduce system load. And there's also the performance mode as well. Now, keep in mind, if you've not gone and watched this video, especially the one from Digital Foundry, this is not magic. Let's be clear about that. I know people really like lossless scaling. It's not lossless, and it's not magic. The more frames you generate, the more it is going to be noticeable. If you're going from a 15 FPS source and then taking it to 60 or taking it to 120, it's gonna be a blurry mess. If you're trying to go from maybe 90 to 180 and then you're running like a 165 hertz monitor, that's going to be a lot less noticeable. This is something you really have to play around with and tweak to get it to the point you're really comfortable with. Also, if you're unsure about how to actually set anything, there is an example down here as well. This project is still very early on and is still very much looking for people to test it. It should be working with most things on Steam. There might be issues, and if you want to be on like the ground floor, trying to make sure everything is as good as it can be from the very start, this is the perfect chance to do so. Now, there are going to be issues with certain games because of the way it works. OpenGL games are not supported. This is a fundamental issue due to how it has to, maybe not has to work, but due to how it currently works on Linux. I'll get into that in a bit, but this is only going to work with things that are running on Vulkan. So that's going to be your DirectX games converting into Vulkan, and then Vulkan native games. If you are not using OpenGL directly and instead doing Zinc, which is OpenGL on top of Vulkan, and this is the direction that things are moving, theoretically that should work. It's not the intention for the project, and most games are not written in OpenGL, but this is something that definitely testing is needed to be done on. Also, I said it before, but let's be very clear. LSFG is lossless scaling frame generation. This is only supporting the frame generation part of lossless scaling. If you want the scaling part, there are various other ways to do that on Linux, but this is not the tool to do so. Granted, most people are looking for the frame gen part anyway, so for most, it's probably not that big of a deal. Now, LSFG is technically not an official port. This is not made by the original developer of Lossless Scaling. At the same time, though, it is being treated very respectfully by the original project, and they actually have a section in the official Lossless Scaling Discord specifically about Linux, and the person making these announcements here, this is the developer of lsfg-vk. So this is the primary location that discussion is being done for the project, and honestly, I think this is a really cool way to handle it, right? Like, the Windows dev, they're focused on the Windows side. They may not know Linux enough to go and do so, but they are willing to let someone who wants to do the Linux side actually go and do the Linux side if they want to. This very quickly became an officially recognized community project, and that is super cool. Now, I mentioned the Linux side does not work at all like the Windows side. So as stated by the dev here, I really hate zooming in on Discord. What an awful platform this is. On a Linux system, there really is no simple and uniform way to capture and insert frames into a game without adding a bunch of latency. Due to this, LSFG-VK uses a Vulkan layer and integrates itself into the game. This brings some very unique challenges with it because not every game, game engine, or even game overlay reacts the same to the modifications. The current approach relies on overriding game settings to enable VSync such that no more synchronization needs to be done by LSFG-VK and it can simply throw out frames to the monitor. This approach has some drawbacks. For example, if you aren't using LSFG-VK to reach your exact monitor's frame rate, but something above or below, the entire synchronization can get thrown off and frame pacing might crumble. at the moment, you should always limit your in-game frame rate to something stable, which then multiplied with LSFG-VK reaches exactly your monitor's refresh rate. Now, because the dev went through a lot of suffering, they did go and make this blog post as well, explaining the process of what they did. This is not a guide. This is not a tutorial. This is an explanation of the psychological torture they went through to make this project work. And that's exactly what I love to talk about. Before doing anything else, step number one was working out how lossless scaling actually works, because lossless scaling is proprietary. So you don't have that same luxury of, hey, everything's open source, I can examine the code and do all this magical stuff. No. So they got out the debugger, they got out the disassembler, and worked out it's basically just a DirectX 11 application. And then you got to work out how you're going to take that thing and do something productive on Linux. The first step to translating DirectX 11 to Vulkan is not to translate DirectX to Vulkan. It's instead to translate DirectX 11 to DirectX 11 and then to Vulkan. This is a quote they made after 2 days of not sleeping. I should have mentioned this earlier. Let's go to their account. I'm a computer science student. Very on brand for someone who would stay up way too long to work on some random side project. When you're trying to translate something that utilizes the GPU, it often comes in multiple parts. The shaders that run on the actual GPU and the pipeline used to coordinate the shaders. Like I said, I didn't translate DirectX 11 to Vulkan just yet. Instead, I used what the Steam Deck, Proton, and native Linux titles from Valve use, DXVK. DXVK is a project that pretends to be DirectX 11 and provides just enough methods to run most, if not all, Windows games written in DirectX 8 to DirectX 11 on Linux. It can also be used natively without Proton and Wine, and that's what I did. They needed something to work out how this actually works and how to hook that into Linux games. Step number one. The shaders. The first step to translating everything to DirectX 11 was to get the shaders to work. That's usually a good first step. Vulkan uses SpearV and DirectX 11 uses DXBC. Thankfully, DXVK can translate the shaders just fine. If it couldn't, we wouldn't be playing DirectX 11 games on Linux through Vulkan. Hopefully that should be working, otherwise I would have no idea how anything else is functioning. I wrote a hook for lossless scaling that intercepted all DirectX 11 calls and dumped the shader files to my computer. Then I took those shader files and copied them over to Linux. I wrote a really small DirectX 11 app that loaded one shader, loaded the texture that I dumped into it, and then dumped the outputs. Voila! WinMerge tells me the files are identical. I did this to a few other shaders until I moved on to actually translating the pipeline. So the goal here was working out what it was actually doing, working out how it was getting anywhere, and that whatever approach that you're taking is actually producing the same result. Step number two, the pipeline. Translating the shader pipeline is the fun part of all of this. I don't know what part of this was fun, but you know, somebody's gonna have fun with it. Attaching RenderDoc to LS on Windows is near impossible because it isn't a game by itself. Current RenderDoc simply does not detect anything and older versions crash immediately. NVIDIA Insight graphics also crash when taking a capture. The solution is a mix of IDA to get the dispatch math, self-written C++ programs to dump the DirectX 11 commands, and a heck ton of WinMerge to compare my shader pipeline with the original. Step by step, I rewrote the shader pipeline in DirectX 11, just like Valve did with Portal 2 until it was done. The process took a huge amount of work, and there were many barricades in the way, like when stuff just wouldn't work for no reason. I'm sure, look, this is the ultimate blocker for everyone who ever tries any programming. Why did this break? No reason. Do I ever work out why? No, there probably was a reason, but I don't care enough to go find out. It works now. That's all that matters. Then we have translating DirectX 11 to Vulkan. Having a working pipeline on Linux now means I can attach a render doc and get the exact Vulkan calls in a neatly organized manner. This was my first time writing something in Vulkan. What is your excuse? Of all the first projects you could take for doing something in Vulkan, porting lossless scaling frame generation to Linux is not the first project I would expect. So I had to do quite a bit of research on Vulkan and read quite a bit of it. Originally, my plan was to keep the DXVK pipeline and simply use Vulkan to hook the game. This plan was cut short, however, because DirectX 11 does not have any synchronization primitives, and Vulkan exclusively worked with synchronization primitives. Since that didn't work, I had to translate the entire pipeline to Vulkan. This process was fairly smooth, and I did it in 27 hours. Consecutive hours of no sleep. Need I remind you? I'm a computer science student. Again, very on brand. And there we have it. The Vulkan pipeline is completed. What follows is a bit of PE parsing to extract shaders from the exe at runtime, so that not everyone using the project needs to go through my painful process. And also, a statically linked subset of DXVK is now used to translate the shaders without actually using DXVK. So, this project right now is still very early on. It's still quite buggy. It's still a bit inconvenient to actually use, and, you know, packages aren't really a thing in most places yet. But this is a step, and this is a step that a lot of people have really wanted to see. So if you're somebody who really desperately needs lossless scaling on Linux, there's somebody doing the work. And that is awesome. Get involved in the Discord. Get involved in the project. I'll leave everything linked in the description down below. Be sure to go check that out. And let me know your thoughts down below as well. If you use lossless scaling, if you even knew what the project was, if you don't understand why anybody actually cares, if you're somebody like me and doesn't like fake frames, I'd love to know. So, if you like the video, go like the video. If you also go subscribe, if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out our Patreon, Scribes, Link, Barapay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I am fake. What is this?